is adventure. Here's romance. Here's O. Henry's famous Robin Hood of the Old West, the Cisco Kid.
On account. 500 in gold.
Now that's what I call real music.
Just wait until you hear the encore. After the job's finished.
Okay, when do we go?
Right away. Pancho's riding into Indian Bluff with the ore samples for the government assayer. I'll handle that end.
And the Cisco Kid?
You'll find him at the Needle Rock Mine. Only don't miss. One thing about Cisco is you never get a second chance. Let's travel.
We weren't worried about you not making it. We've got the ore samples all ready for you.
And man, what samples? Let me show you. I've seen a lot of gold-bearing rock in my day, but I never saw anything could tie that outside of the mother lode.
Mother lode? Maybe she got a whole family and a little sister living right here, right?
I hope you're right, Pancho. Mama Cedar Lotus can have just as many little sisters living here as she wishes.
Okay, Pancho, I guess it's all up to you now. You know, you got a tough ride into the county seat.
Oh, tough ride, 30 miles. Loco can do that with one foot tied behind his back, and especially if I got my good horse with me, my lucky one, huh?
Come along, amigo, before you have Loco riding you to Indian Bluffs.
When he gets back from Indian Bluff with the assayer's report on that ore, well, you're going to be a pretty rich young lady, Miss Terry.
Somehow that doesn't seem so important now. If Dad were only here to see it.
And hurry back. We'll be here. Pancho, don't get in any trouble.
Oh, Cisco, don't worry. I won't get in no trouble. I'll hurry back and we'll get back before you can say... Well, before you can say...
Jack Robinson.
Who?
Jack Robinson.
Jack Robinson? That's some fellow you want me to look up in the town for you?
No, Pancho. Jack Robinson is just an expression. I've never been to this town. I don't have any friends there.
That's a good way for me to get into trouble, looking up friends you don't got, eh?
Oh, Pancho, please hurry.
Yes, if I see this friend of yours, Jack Robinson, I'll tell him you don't know him, huh?
I think we'd better be getting back.
Oh, sure. Well, I guess I'll take Miss Terry back to Ogden Grove now that you're here to look out for things, Cisco.
Bye, Cisco.
I'm afraid he wasn't as fortunate as you were, Cisco. The force of the explosion appears to have broken his neck. He's gone.
I don't understand it, Doctor. I'm sure this man started the fire. As sure as I am, he was about to shoot me when I happened to see him. But I have no idea who he is or why he wanted to kill me.
Let's make it out a death certificate for that fella. Thought you and he were about the same build. If I just knew who he was, I could finish making this out.
Perhaps if I were to spell the name, Doctor.
Huh? I thought you said you'd never seen him before.
I realize what I'm asking you to do, Dr. Shaw. The name for that certificate is Cisco. Spelled C-I-S-C-O.
Amigo, what's the matter? You hurt?
Here's some water, please.
Yeah, I bring some water for you.
Here, take.
Huh? Now, don't drink too much because you're going to get sick to your stomachache. Huh?
Thanks.
What happened?
My horse threw me a couple miles back.
Your horse? Well, why don't you go on my horse? He ride double.
Much obliged, mister.
Bueno. Give me the water. Come on.
Take.
You like to people, my horse.
I want you to understand I'm very grateful for all this.
Don't worry, I understand everything.
Thanks a lot for the ride into town.
Hey, don't thank me, thank Loco.
Well, I guess I'd better be moving along. I hope I'll be able to repay you someday, Pancho.
Oh, no. For the ride, you are welcome, senor. But, you know, I must ask you for the horse samples you take from my saddle bag, eh?
I don't know what you're talking about. Horse samples? What do you mean?
Oh, I mean, senor, I mean that this is a very good chance for you to meet the sheriff of Indian Bluff, eh? This way, senor. I knew he was a dirty crook when he told the story about being thrown down from his horse.
I suppose you've never been thrown from your horse. It isn't possible.
It would be possible. I was thrown many times from my horse, but I never did see a man walk along a dusty road with a shiny bush like him.
Now, listen, Pancho.
What?
Let's start all over again. You want me to arrest this man, but what's the charge? What did he do besides have his shoes polished?
What he did, he took the sample of the gold from my saddlebags.
Oh, now we're getting somewhere. What have you got to say for yourself?
The whole thing's ridiculous. I don't know anything about any ore samples. If there ever were any in his saddlebags, then they must still be there. Why don't we go look before we waste any more time?
Because I got a better idea. That bulge under your coat, suppose you have a look at that before you go anywhere.
All right. And you're going to feel pretty silly when you see what it is, too.
Hey, what about this? Open up, Sheriff.
That's ore-bearing rock, all right. I guess you're in trouble, mister. Come on. And you're lucky you didn't get that gun out of your pocket. You can really throw a gun, Pancho.
I'm a crippled old woman as compared with Cisco.
All right, get in there.
I don't think so. Look behind you. All right, now you get in. You too. All right, Winkler, let's go. Catch up with you here, Winkler. Watching Cisco's funeral.
I just got back from the mine when I got your note. What's the matter? Somebody close to you has died?
And you haven't heard?
Oh, I just got back from Indian Bluff when I got your note.
What happened to your face? An explosion? So that's what happened to the Cisco Kid. And you got burned. Your face, is it bad? Can't talk, huh? Well, that's all right. I'll do the talking for both of us. You know, it ought to be worth a little extra money when I tell the boss about it.
Cisco.
Anywhere you look at it, the boss is getting his money's worth out of that funeral. Taking the Needle Rock mine away from the girl now ought to be like stealing candy from a baby.
Pancho, look. The man with the bandaged face. That's the way Dr. Shaw described the one who brought Cisco to his office.
And he's riding Cisco's horse, Diablo. Come on, boys. I want to talk to that hombre.
Thank you. We lost him.
He was going too fast.
Sure, he was on Diablo, Cisco's horse. But he won't always be on Diablo. Then will be a different story. And Pancho's turn will come then.
My neck again. Thanks. I don't know about you, Winkler, but I'm ready to get out of here as soon as we get the rest of our money. You coming? Why not? Oh, you got to go back to the doctor. Huh? I'll see you later.
Oh, inevitably.
Don't take it so hard, Pancho.
But, senorita, we come just this close from capturing this bandaged bandit. And if he didn't was riding Diablo, he ain't just a murderer. He's a horse thief, too.
I don't understand any of this. Cisco's death and them stealing the ore sample from you at Indian Bluff. What's the connection, Pancho?
Senorita, this I don't understand. Maybe I better have a little talk with Dr. Shaw. Maybe he can tell me more about the man who killed Cisco, eh? Adios, senorita.
Goodbye, Pancho.
You're the first patient I ever had insisted on wearing a bandage, but he didn't have to.
You forget, Doctor. I have to if I'm going to find out who paid to have me killed.
I understand. I suppose when Kramer stops talking, all sorts of people come crowding in here asking questions. What'll I tell them?
Tell them anything, Doctor, except where to find me.
Well, what about Pancho? Shall I tell him?
You'll have to tell Pancho, because he'll make you do it.
Oh, so I meet up with you, Senor Bandage Head. I am Pancho. You killed my friend Cisco. I ought to shoot you down like a dirty dog, which you are. But I'm going to give you a chance. That's more I do for my friend. Oh. Start walking this way. And shoot whenever you like. Senor Bandit Head, you better draw. Don't tell me there's a chicken's head under that bandage. I will count to three. You better draw. One, two. Draw, senor, or you will die with your gun in your holster. Three.
You're all right, Pancho.
Yes, Doctor, I'm all right, you know. Pancho, he always, he cries when he's so happy.
And you know it was Cisco. I don't have to tell you.
Sure, who else could shoot a gun like that?
Was he here, Pancho? The man with the bandaged head. We heard some shooting.
Sure he was here.
He got away again, huh?
Looked like a ghost, too.
Malcolm came by to pick me up a few minutes after you left. We're going to take some new ore samples over to Indian Bluff.
Maybe I better went with you, because you can never tell when those bandidos will show up, huh?
Oh, thanks, Pancho. But that won't be necessary. We better get going, Malcolm. Bye, Pancho.
Bye. Say, Doc, did Cisco tell you where you're going to went to?
Well, he said something about having a room at the hotel.
Y bueno.
Well,
I guess you're pretty excited, aren't you, Miss Terry?
I don't know whether to laugh or cry. I just close my eyes and keep my fingers crossed.
Well, I don't think you've got anything to worry about.
I hope you're right, Jeff.
Good afternoon, folks. What do we have here?
That's what we want you to tell us.
All right. We just fill this out. Your name, please?
Teresa Lane.
Name and location of your claim?
Needle Rock Mine near Ogden Grove.
Something wrong?
Well, I don't know. I just finished running a test on some rock from that mine.
There must be some mistake.
No mistake, Miss Lane. Here it is. Name of owner, Teresa Lane. Needle Rock Mine, Ogden Grove.
But this is impossible. Who brought the rock in here?
I did. What did you find?
You have a real strike, Miss Lane. The basis of the specimens this gentleman left with me ought to run, several thousand dollars a ton.
Just a minute. We don't know this man.
I know this man.
Yeah, but how do we know the samples that came from the Needle Rock Mine?
And I know the Needle Rock Mine. The samples came by the way of me and the sheriff's office.
Well, I guess in that case, there's no use of having these assayed.
As long as you bring them, why don't you let the man look at them, eh?
But you heard what he said. Showing him these won't prove anything.
Let him look at them anyway.
I can tell you right now, this is a very inferior ore. There's hardly any trace of color to it.
What are you smiling at, senor?
Drop that gun. Come on, Winkler.
That's not Winkler. Let's get out of here.
Stick your head out this door and I'll blast you.
You stay here. I'll go out the back way.
Like a little kitty cat with nine
Cisco, did you catch that Malcolm?
Sure, Pancho.
How did you did it?
Oh, it was very easy. I just took off my bandage, and when he saw my face, he fainted.
Oh, Cisco!
Oh, Pancho!
Goodbye, amigos.